All right, guys, let's do this number 4D right here. All right, I'm going to attack the right side because that one looks kind of crazy. So I'm gonna first take out a cosine squared x from each of those terms. So that's from three terms. And when I take that out, I'm going to write it like that. Whoops. Sorry, guys. Didn't mean to show my whole plan at once. But I'll take out the cosine squared x, and so I have cosine squared x times sine x. Now, I don't know if you guys see the factoring problem right here, but I'm going to show you what it looks like if it didn't have cosine there. It just had an x. So you would have 1 minus 2x squared plus x to the fourth. And this is a perfect square trinomial. So that means if I had 1 minus x squared times 1 minus x squared, you would get this. And I saw that because that was a perfect square. That guy's a perfect square. And because that's minus right there, I knew that this would be 1 and this would be x squared. And I knew that just by taking the square root of each of these bad mamma jammas. All right, so now, if I rewrite this over here, we would have 1 minus cosine squared x and 1 minus cosine squared x, just like these guys over here. And then we have cosine squared x times sine x. Now, you should recognize these guys because that's a Pythagorean identity. Each of those guys equals sine squared x. So if I take them out and just put sine squared x into both of those, this is what I got. And then I just have to multiply each of these signs together. And since I'm multiplying those together, I have to add all the what are these things called? Exponents. This one has a 1. So that's 2, 2, and 1, which means I would have a sine to the fifth x times cosine squared x, which is exactly what I was trying to get. I was trying to get it to look like that. I know there's other ways to do this. That's the way I chose to do it, just because the right side looked more complicated than the left side. So if you got it a different way, awesome. Just make sure you stay on one side and try to make that side look like the other side. Okay, you can't do like inverse operations where you do something to both sides. You could only simplify and manipulate one side to make it look like the other side.